In 1987, I became an architect. So it is today 30 years. I always thought that to be an architect was not simply to have chosen a field or a job. It was closer to a second nature, where you risk to forget you had the first one. Second nature is a term the Romans introduced to define transformations related to agriculture, water management, or road construction they realized along the centuries. They are man-made landscapes, so deeply reconfigured existing natural landscapes to last for millennia, that they were read as new nature. To be an architect is then, from my perspective, a second nature, which is hardly distinguishable from the first one and always present, even when you do not work or think to projects. It forges new eyes to look at the world, new feet to walk in the territory, new hands to sketch, map, and draw, a new brain that thinks while designing. In these first 30 years as an architect, I had the chance to reflect and imagine at the highest degree about the future of large metropolitan areas as Great Paris or Brussels, imagining at different scales places to live together and to share the experience of nature as in the wooden ring to live in, we realized in the forest of the Hoge Rillen. Belgium and Flanders have been fundamental in our work as architects and urbanists. In 1989, our imagination was highly intrigued by Flanders. Together with Bernardo Secchi, we started a long-lasting love relation with this part of Europe. Slowly, we developed also a few ideas about the quality of its landscapes and lifestyles, of its ancient and contemporary culture, about its future. In Antwerp, this relation was particularly intense, and we could merge spatial and social imagination designing the Antwerp structural plan, Parcs Por Nord and Theater Plein. After such a long time, I do not think I know Belgium and Flanders better. I'm always enchanted by the richness of any situation and by the possibilities and potentialities we can read in space. Questions have partially changed, as well as populations, social expectations, territories and goals. But today, even more clear than in the past, architects and urbanists can give a contribution with their imagination to the social construction of hope. The possibility of change, even of a radical change, still has to be affirmed and intellectually maintained. Yours sincerely, Paola Viganò.